Games 1-2 to what we saw in Game 3, what enabled Toronto to generate as much speed as we did, or was it that much different from what we saw in Boston?
I think we just went quick up as soon as we got it every time. I mean, we were quick on transition. I think when we're doing that, that's when we're at our best.
What works to generating that transition and getting it going?
Obviously, hard work. I think coming back to the puck, I mean, talking to our D-man, I think trying to get open for him quicker, that's just, you know, makes a big difference when we're coming back and talking and helping out.
Some of the Bruins yesterday, they seem to think their big line got chances, they just didn't convert, and that was a big difference from games 1 and 2 for them. Did you see it similarly, or did you feel like you were really doing a better job against them?
Oh, they definitely had chances. I mean, every line gets chances. I mean, obviously at the end of the game, I mean, you know, that open net Fred made a save on, so they definitely had their chances. I mean, things are going to happen in games. I mean, mistakes are going to happen. There's chances that come into those mistakes, so... But as a line, I thought we played well. I mean, I thought we tried to limit their chances as much as possible, keep them the outside. So, you know, that's what we're going to have to do next game to try and be successful.
The Habs were in town earlier in the regular season. Gallagher was saying he learned a lot from playing with Plekanec. He always seemed to know little things about his team. He's got a lot of experience with the Bruins. Did you pick up on that?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, you know, Montreal and Boston go a long way back in playoff series as well. And, I mean, he's been in majority of them. So he's a guy that's always been that role that, you know, is... you know, hard to play against. He doesn't give a lot of chances offensively, but you know, playing with him last game, you know, he's talking a lot on the bench, you know, just helping out every play. So you know, that's something you need. You need people talking to you and helping you out.
Could you tell Bergeron and Marchand there was no love lost between them and him?
Definitely, yeah. I mean, you could see the battle out there. Like I said, I mean, it's been they've played each other a couple times in the playoffs. It's you know, it's usually, I think, Plekky going against that line. So I mean, you could see the battle going on. You know, I think it, you know, showed.
You mentioned puck sense and tenacity and all of these things in transition. I comment on Patrick's ability to read a game and to jump in as quickly as it is, and with all due respect, at his age, to be as fast as he is.
Yeah, it's crazy. I mean, he's one of the fast guys on our team. You know, he's always moving his feet. He's always aware of the play. He's very good at reading the play as well. So it's been a lot of fun playing with him. He's got a lot of experience, and I mean, on and off the ice, he's been a huge mentor.
Now, what a privilege it is, given the amount of players in your young career you've been able to play with so far, isn't it?
Yeah, no, definitely. I mean, I've been very lucky, played with a lot of great players. So, you know, you can always learn off those players and, you know, get better. And, you know, it's been a lot of fun.